Here come the Redhawks.
Frontier Redhawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Aaron Landry is going to go all the way to the house. Landry gets the outside again.
Lovely on the carry.
Breaks through and he's into the end zone. He is dropped in the backfield by Kieran Freeman. First handoff. Nice little bit of razzle dazzle there as the handoff went to Worley, then it went to Landry, and Landry's off to the races. Touchdown! No Wanter just plowed through three or four tacklers.
Welcome to Frontier Regional School for today's Intercounty League football matchup. Today the Redhawks welcome the Greenway from Greenfield High School. Starting offense for the Greenway. The center is number 72, Marty Brown. The tackles are 74, Laz Santiago. And number 77, Colby Avery. Guard number 58, Colin Cloutier. And number 66, Matt Griswold. The tight end is number 38, Nate Hazelton. Flanker, number 10, Owen Phelps. Wide receiver is number 88, Jesus Rodriguez. Fullback, 43, Tyler Townsley. The halfback is 22, R.J. Bird. And at quarterback for the Green Wave, number 11, Tyler Miner. The Wave is coached by Mr. Mike Kachewski. Starting lineup for your Frontier Redhawks. The center is number 55, Jonathan Delaney. The guards are 79, Matt Carlson, and number 73, Kate DeWanter. Tackles, number 66, Luke Parsons, and number 63, Joel Hildreth. Tight end is number 15, Cole Price. Split end is 42, Joe Morowski. Fullback is 45, Seth DeWanter. Halfbacks, 20, Worthley, and 28, Aaron Landry. And taking a snap to the Redhawks is number 10, Miles Freeman. The Redhawks are coached by Mr. Don Gordon.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to South Deerfield Frontier Regional today. An Intercounty League North matchup. It's the Frontier Redhawks taking on the Greenfield Greenways. I'm Jeff Tirrell, Sean Hubert alongside our studio producer this afternoon. Pinch hitting for Dave Reno is Matt Gregory. Great to have you with us here. It is Booster Day here in South Deerfield. Sean, it's always a big event and a big football game here as the Frontier Redhawks look to keep the winning ways going against the Wave.
Yeah, always nice, and you pull in and you see the little guys out there chucking the football around and folks out playing tennis, and pretty nice day for it. A little overcast, but a little cool, but not bad. A great day for football. Interesting matchup here today. We've seen both of these teams already. We kind of know what Greenfield is. We know that their game is predicated on defense, that they're not going to give up a lot of points. But where do you start in Frontier?
That's very true. They have an outstanding offensive attack, particularly on the ground, and it is far from just one guy. And that was evident last week in their 66-28 win over the Tech School.
Look at these numbers. You know, you just look at, okay, so three guys running for over 100 yards on the same team.
That's just not fair.
I'll tell you what, if you like to watch guys run the football, Dylan Malu for Franklin Tech kicked in 43 carries and 247 yards in this game, too. But Seth Gawanter, 8 carries, 148 yards. Landry ended up with 6 carries, 131. And Worthley was 6 carries, 124 yards. 429 yards rushing, 60 passing, almost 500 yards total offense against Franklin Tech last week. We were impressed with Tech's defense against Mohawk. But then the Redhawks rolled in. So now we know Greenfield has a good defense. I'm curious to see how good they are.
Yeah, Greenfield hasn't quite faced an offense this diverse. Well, of course, they came off that 8-0 loss to the Turner's Falls Indians, which has an offense comparable to Frontier. But the Green Wave defensively can get it done, but asking them to do it for a full four quarters against this Frontier attack, very much in doubt.
Frontier has won the toss and will receive the opening kickoff. Still need one on the chains.
You start yelling out 2-3 zone or something, I know you're doing the wrong sport.
Oh,
And a nice job there by the Frontier Regional Marching Band as we get set for football here on a Saturday afternoon, a rare late start, but always nice, Sean. You know, when we first got into this, we did our fair share of Saturday afternoon games, but that's sadly, for me anyway, is kind of giving way to Friday night football, which is fun, but it's when we get these rare Saturday afternoon games, it kind of brings us back to the old days.
Yeah, we've had a few this season, and again, the weather just about perfect for football, really. Not too hot, not too sunny. Just a slight overcast and perfect weather for football.
Frontier undefeated on the year. Greenfield at 1-3 after their loss 8-0 to Turners. Frontier a 66-28 victor at Franklin Tech. Both of the games I just mentioned were on Bear Country. Now we see the Wave and the Redhawks going toe-to-toe here. Greenfield will be kicking as Frontier won the opening toss, and they will be receiving Tyler Townsley as it teed up on the 40-yard line. Greenfield in their visiting white jerseys with the gray pants and the green helmets, and the Frontier Redhawks in their home.
Freeman back to return for the Redhawks.
Red jerseys and the navy blue pants, the navy blue helmet. 11-minute quarters, and we are set for football here. The Greenfield D about to get tested on this opening drive from that very powerful Frontier offense. Townsley with a line drive kick right center of the field. Picked up on the right hash mark and
Steve
taken Wordley for a short return for Stephen Wordley. Out across the 35-yard line.
First and 10.
Jesus Rodriguez on the stop for Greenfield. He'll stay right out there and play safety for the way. First down and 10. Miles Freeman, the starting quarterback, coming out. And he did a lot of handing the ball off last week. And if it's not broke, don't fix it,
no,
right?
He threw it a few times as well. But, yeah, you know, typically when we think about Frontier, we think about defense. But the numbers so far, this team 3-0, they've scored 144 points in three games.
Freeman throwing on first down, right down the middle field, wide open is Cole Grice. He's going to take it all the way. Touchdown. One play. Touchdown. 62 yards. 6-0 Redhawks.
Well, we saw that last night. The Mahar Senators, the Indians got the opening drive. They took it in for a score, and then the first play of the game for the Senators, they did the exact same thing, and Miles Freeman just rolled out. He had plenty of time, and the receiver was wide open. All he had to do was reach out, make the catch, and glide right into the end zone. So first play of the game. We just talked about how many points they've scored this season. Tack on six more.
Hawks will go for two, and they give it to Stephen Wordley. And let's see, delayed call. Looks like he may have fallen just shy. They are saying that his knee was down. So the two-point conversion is no good. We'll step aside for a timeout. 10:44 to play here in the opening quarter. And just like that, on the conquest of Greenfield, South Deerfield and Shelburne scoreboard, Frontier 6 and Greenfield nothing.
To kick off for Frontier. Back for the Green Wave, 22, R.J. Bird.
All right, Frontier now set to boot it away now. As Corbin Blight, a freshman, has a teed up. He did a lot of kicking last week. He did a lot of kicking out of bounds, as I recall. But with the Tech's goal, we'll see where he hits this one. R.J. Bird is the deep man. He kind of tops it, and it'll come down to Bird at the 25-yard line. And great downfield coverage by the Redhawks. RJ trying to cut back against the seam, but he's not going to make it. A lot of running for not much of a return. Great downfield coverage by the Hawks.
Yep, nice job there, but nice to see RJ Bird on the field for the Green Wave. Could have been a big difference maker against Turner's Falls a week ago. Again, Turner's Falls wins that one 8-0. And without RJ Bird, his first three games of the season, 17 carries, 32 yards against McCann, and then against the Mahar Senators, 18 carries, he exploded for 180 yards and three touchdowns. And against Belchertown, 27 carries and 108 yards. So 82 carries, 386 yards in three games for Bird, and Greenfield's offense can certainly use a shot in the arm that he's going to provide.
Junior center, Marty Brown brings him up. Backs are in the I formation. Townsley and Bird wideouts on either side. Tyler Miner will hand to Bird on the right side. He is swarmed under. He got the handoff and he got hit. The Gowanters, Cade and Seth, were both waiting for him. Loss of 3 yards.
Loss of two, actually,
back to the 20. It'll be second down and 12.
Yeah, both the Gowanters, probably with their cousins, too, back there. And they, after, I mean, as soon as that ball was snapped, Bird took the ball and absolutely nowhere to go on the right side.
Second down and long for Greenfield, trailing 6-0 right out of the gate here on that first play from scrimmage, touchdown pass 62 yards for the Hawks. Backs again in the eye. They go back to Bird on the right side, a little more running room this time as he brings it back out to the 25-yard line. That's a gain of about 7 yards there. It'll be third down and seven for Greenfield.
That's the explosion that R.J. Bird has through the line. Again, just a sophomore, this kid. You can just see he's got that quick first step and start to see he's starting to get a good vision of the field and where to cut back too. But this, again, this is a tough defense he's going to try to run against today. A couple carries there, one carry for Bird, two carries for Bird, and 4 yards right now.
Bird now will go, backs are split this time. The pitch is going to go to Bird on the left side. Frontier, though, waiting for him again. He lowers the shoulder, but he is swarmed under back at the 21-yard line. So he's got two carries for losses. A nice gain of seven on his second attempt, but it'll be fourth and 11. Obvious punting situation for the Wave.
Yeah, so net three carries minus 2 yards for Bird on that drive. Those were the only three plays of the drive where Bird carries. And
Tyler Miner back to punt for Greenfield.
Going backwards just a little bit. Frontier will end up with very good field position to start their second drive of this game.
Frontier looking like they are coming after Tyler Miner, the punter. He's standing at his own 10-yard line. Here they come. And it is blocked. It's blocked. It's picked up by Frontier, and they have it inside the 5-yard line. Not sure who got it. I know Seth Galanta was in the neighborhood, but they blocked the punt. You can see, Sean, they were coming right at Miner.
That was Galanta. Yeah, again, big kid, 5'9", 215, and boy, that hit him right in the chest. I mean, he was there.
3-yard line.
And then there was a teammate trying to scoop it up, take it into the end zone, and not quite there, but it's going to be first and goal inside the five for the Red Hawks.
Ball is spotted right around that 4-yard line or so. 3 or 4 yard line. First and goal for Frontier. They're going to work a little reverse and taking it in easily on the left side.
Miles
touchdown,
Freeman.
Miles Freeman, the quarterback. He kind of handed off. They pitched it right back. He cruises into the end zone. Freeman. It's 12-0.
Now let's see here. We're about a minute and a half into this football game, and Miles Freeman has run for a touchdown, thrown for a touchdown, and the Red Hawks off to a quick start. About the worst case scenario for the Green Wave right here. Down 12, the Red Hawks going to line up to go for two.
They failed on their first attempt. And this time they are going to give it on the right side. And Stephen Wortley, did he get knocked back again? He did not quite make it in. Laz Santiago has made a bottom down. We'll take another timeout. 8:25 left to play here in the opening quarter on the conquest of Greenfield, South Deerfield, and Shelburne scoreboard. It's Frontier 12, Greenfield nothing.
Corbin Blight to kick off. R.J. Bird back to receive for Greenfield.
Here's the kick now. It's a topper, and it is taken by one of the up men for Greenfield. And he is swarmed under by the Frontier Red Hawks. They never did officially tackle him. Nice attempt to return there by Jared Hart, a freshman. And he's knocked back. Let's see, with this forward momentum, he got it out across the 35. We'll call it the 37. First and 10
first
for
and
Greenfield. They went three and out
37-yard line.
On their opening drive, had the punt blocked. First play from scrimmage, touchdown. This has been it's been a long afternoon already. We haven't even played very long.
No, about a minute and a half into this one. And yeah, first possession minus 2 yards and then a blocked punt.
This fairly young Greenfield team, just a sprinkling of seniors on it. And having a tough time so far. I formation. They give it to R.J. Bird on the right side. Turns the corner. Nice run
for
Bird.
Oh, he lost the ball.
Lost the football. Big battle for it. Frontier looks like they got it right at midfield. Let's see what the officials say, though. Frontier got it. So a nice run by Bird. He had a first down up at midfield. And then he coughs the ball up, and it goes right back to Frontier.
He did a great job. He got to the outside again, made himself skinny, and then trying to pick up a few extra yards along the sideline. At the end of the play, he got popped. You saw the ball fly out of there, and the Redhawks take over. So Bird, gain of about 12 on the carry.
Shawn, how do you make yourself skinny? Because I'd like to do that.
Well, some guys can and some guys can't. And guys like you and I.
Evidently can't.
Yeah, speed, skinny, none of them things.
First and 10 for Frontier at the midfield stripe. Already leading 12 to nothing. Inside give is going to go for 9 yards. That's going to be Seth Gawantra, I believe. We will see. Yeah, that's big. No, that's Aaron Landry,
Aaron
number 28. We'll give him 9.
First down.
Really, more like 9.5. It's second down and very short.
Yeah, just the third offensive play run. Again, the Freeman touchdown pass and a 4-yard TD run for him as well.
This Frontier team is scary good.
Well, you know, they were scary against Tech last weekend, but if they're going to do this to Greenfield, they're very scary.
Aaron Landry, left side, has the first down.
First down.
Over left tackle. And he brings the ball to the 38-yard line. First
Matt
down
Griswold
and
10. On the
tackle made by
Greenfield.
Matt Griswold.
Kind of compared him last night to Turner's Falls, but a little bit bigger, I think. You know, they've got the pieces. You got the fullback that's big. You got a couple of complimentary runners that are fast. You got a quarterback that can throw the ball. These guys are just a little bit bigger.
Yeah, the give this time is up the middle. Nice gain there. That looks like it was Worthley, number
Steve
29.
Yeah,
it was Steve. Nice gain to the 31-yard line, 32-yard line, we'll call it. We'll give him a gain about 6 right there, second and 4. 7 minutes to play in the opening quarter. Frontier leading 12-0, and they're on the march again. Greenfield searching for answers. Not a bad defensive team this year, but
second
again,
four,
offensively,
four.
Frontier is the just
Hawks.
Off the charts good. Inside give to Seth Gawantra, keeping the pile moving,
Gawantra
and his forward momentum was impeded after a gain of a yard to the 31. And that'll bring about a third down. Now, this is where Greenfield excelled against Turner's. They forced Turner's
Brown in the middle of the play.
Into a lot of situations where they were unable to convert on third down.
Well, the other thing Greenfield did well against Turner's was not turn the ball over.
Right.
Again, that was the problem early on. They were in all three of their games, only winning one, but the turnovers killed them.
And the handoff on the right side, Stephen Wordley. And he will move the chains, I believe. He needed to get to the 28 for the first. Well, we will see. Maybe just a little bit short. It'll be fourth down here, actually. Fourth and one.
Fourth and one for Frontier.
And they will go here for sure.
Sure they will go.
Saw something fly out of there. I thought it was the football. It was a helmet.
It was a helmet, yeah. Helmet popped off. No head was in it, fortunately.
No. Haven't seen that yet.
No. Don't want to see that, actually.
No.
All right, fourth and one from the Greenfield 29. Frontier leading 12 to nothing. They give Landry left side,
Aaron
first
Landry
down, and a lot more. Breaks free, and he is gone. Touchdown. 18-0 Frontier.
Yep, just like that. Aaron Landry, he's had some big games against East Hampton. 13 carries, 203 yards, and 3 touchdowns. We talked about the game last week. Landry, 6 carries, 131 yards. And he's off to a good start here again today. 3 carries for Aaron Landry, 43 yards, and he's into the end zone. And just like that, the Redhawks opening this thing up 18-0 now. We're 4.5 minutes into the first quarter.
About the only thing they haven't done right is converting on their twos. They'll try right here. Wordley has it in the backfield, and he breaks free of a couple of tackles and finally is knocked down at the 2-yard line. The conversion is no good. Timeout on the field, 5 minutes, 31 seconds left to play here in the opening quarter. And our score, the conquest of Greenfield, South Deerfield and Shelburne scoreboard. Frontier 18, Greenfield nothing. Back after this on Bear Country 95.3. Blake kicks it, it goes by R.J. Bird. He goes back to get it. Stutter Steps makes a nice return. up to the 25-yard line. Looked like he was going to be swarmed under back around his own 10.
Yeah, it was a nice job by Bird. The ball, right before it hit to him, he was waiting for the kick, and then it just took a dead right turn. Like one of my drives today, actually, and he had to go chase that thing down, and the Redhawks got down pretty quickly. So nice job by Bird to actually get that thing out to the 25-yard line.
You guys didn't tear up Thomas Memorial Golf Club, but you did pretty well.
Okay, yeah, 8-under,
eight under.
Bad. Yeah, 4 in the front, 4 in the back.
Yeah, you know.
Nice day for it. The Turner Falls Alumni Association, nice, this was their inaugural tournament, and nice job by them.
Tyler Miner rolls to the left. The lefty quarterback tucks it under. Here will take off. And he gets hit hard after a short game. Miner, a pretty tough kid. He took some big-time shots in the games that we have covered this season. We've seen two Greenfield games, and he's been hit hard numerous times.
Well, we know these Red Hawks are here to hit. I mean, that's what they do, especially on defense. And we saw it. They put their JV in at the end of the game against the Franklin Tech Eagles last week, and those kids were hitting hard.
Nate Hazelton was in on that last play. He now will check out.
Second and eight for the Green Wave.
Second down and eight for the Wave. Townsley and Bird in the I formation behind Tyler Miner. Wide outs to either side. Tight ends lined up on the right. They give to Bird on the right side, looking for running room, but it's just not there. Frontier's able to stack him up. Cade Gawanter was among those in there. Also number, Cade Gawanter. Third and long for the Wave. They actually gave him about a yard.
Third and six for the Green Wave.
Right, third and six for the Wave, trailing 18-0 with still 4 minutes left here in the opening quarter.
Yeah, 14 yards total offense here so far for Greenfield. Tyler Miner, a 3-yard run, and R.J. Bird, 5 carries for 11. Of course, he fumbled at the end of the long run. He had a 12-yard run, but coughed it up at the end.
Owen Phelps and Jesus Rodriguez come to the near side left, back to in the I formation behind Miner. He will drop back to pass. Heavy rush. They're trying to set up a screen, and it is caught but snuffed out. Townsley made the catch, but Frontier could see what was happening. They had the linebackers
Miner's
waiting for him.
Complete
fourth and long.
Once you have that many linemen in the backfield, you turn around and realize what's happening, but the interior of the linebacking core stays home, and
Green Wave,
it'll be the first completed pass
seven
for Tyler Miner, but it actually looks
Greenfield
like it's going to lose a yard.
Yard line. Tyler Miner back to punt for the Wave.
Miner had his first punt blocked. Aaron Landry back to it around the 45, so the Hawks will get very good field position here, barring something crazy. Miner had a very good night punting against Turner's Falls last week. Here come the Hawks again. Miner, though, gets away a line drive kick. Takes a bit of a Greenfield roll inside the 45, spotted down by Phelps
at the
42, and that is where the Hawks now will take over. And they've had a very nearly perfect afternoon so far, Sean. The only thing that they flubbed are their conversion attempts. They're 0 for 3. Other than that, it's going as designed.
I was going to say, if it was like a QBR system, yeah, they're hitting all the high points right now. Miles Freeman, 1 of 1 passing, 62 yards, a touchdown. 1 carry for Freeman as well, 4 yards into the end zone for a touchdown. Again, Landry, Worthley, Gawanter, 6 carries, 60 yards. And Landry into the end zone already as well.
First and 10 for the Hawks, moving left to right here on their next drive. And a short gain that time for Stephen Worthley. Maybe a yard. Greenfield waiting for him. Greenfield going to get a little fired up here now.
Worthley on a carry.
Nate Hazelton was there, along with Colin Cloutier.
Short game.
Well, when you talk about the main names for Greenfield, at least right now, you're seeing a lot of, you look at the roster, you're seeing a lot of JR and SOs
yep.
in there, juniors and sophomores.
Yep, good sign.
And off up the middle, and Worthley kind of squirts through like a wet bar of soap, and he gets a first down into Greenfield territory. At the 46, the Wave was there, but he was able to find the seam.
So would that be making yourself slippery? Would that be that kind of run? That'd be a slippery run.
When they're not making themselves skinny, they're making themselves slippery.
He was slippery on that one.
He was.
Actually, at one point, it looked like he was just going to dive forward, and he was low to the ground and kept his footing, and ended up picking the head back up, and yeah, nice run there by Worthley. 4 carries, 23 yards for him.
First and 10 from the Greenfield 46-yard line. Back to pass. Wide open again is Price. A little bit underthrown, but he still catches him. Colin Kasuda catches him from behind inside the 20-yard line. Freeman, had he caught him in stride, Price, that would have gone for six because Price was wide open.
26 yards on that connection, and he had enough time. Actually, he was looking over his left shoulder, had plenty of time to find the ball, turn around, look over his right shoulder, get spun around, and in position to make the catch. But you're right, if that ball was thrown about 5 yards further downfield, that was into the end zone again.
17-yard line.
17-yard line of Greenfield, first down and 10. Aaron Landry on the left side. He brings it inside the 15. Yeah, what Price looked like on that, he reminded me of a baseball outfielder who's tracking a fly ball, realizes he turned the wrong way, recovers, and then just settles under it and makes the catch. That's what that looked like.
Well, and it's bad defense when you have time to do all of that.
Exactly.
And that's the thing where the ball's coming and you gotta track it, and that, there's no way you should have enough time to do all that, but he did, he was so wide open.
Second down and 5. It is Landry, bounces to the outside.
Oh,
it's a
Landry.
Nice block, accelerates along the sideline, and he has a first down.
Redhawks.
Inside the Greenfield 10-yard line, he nearly scored.
Touchdown, they're calling it, he said he got in.
I think they're marking him inside the 5.
He got in the corner there, but yeah, you're right. He was out of bounds.
Call it the 3-yard line of Greenfield, but they're knocking on the door again. You have the idea that they'll be in soon enough. The way things have gone so far anyway.
I would say it's fourth down and goal, but no chance they can knock this one in. Be a good stand for Greenfield, they can stop it.
Rolling to the left. Freeman glides into the end zone. Touchdown, Frontier.
101 remaining here. The first quarter, Redhawks 26, Greenway nothing.
How's your day, Miles Freeman? You know, I don't know, 2 for 2 passing, 88 yards. I got 2 carries for 8 yards. Oh, and 2 other touchdowns.
And they convert. Oh. Finally, they finally do convert there on the 2-pointer. So they now lead 26-0. So there was definitely some confusion there. One of the officials had marked him down. He was in on the 2-point conversion. And the Hawks now 26-0.
Blake. To kick off for the Hawks,
21 left here in the first quarter.
The Green Wave.
Blight has a teed up on the 40. Bird is at the 10. All right, here we go. After a little bit of a delay, get a line drive kick. It goes by Bird. Back
down
to the 10.
He's
on his knee. Oh, they should have called him down. Yeah, they did call him down. He had his foot down, his knee down, as he possessed the ball. So that's an automatic, you are down right there. And to add to Greenfield's woes, they're starting off just across their own 5-yard line.
Well, you see this a lot of times, especially with R.J. Bird, the way the ball's been skipping on him back there. And he ran around behind to try to corral it. Went down to a knee like a baseball player would. Again, you possess the ball, you're on a knee, you gave yourself up. May not have had much of a return after that anyway. The Redhawks were there, but yeah, bad starting field position here for Greenfield. It's already down 26-0.
Townsley and Bird are the backs in the eye. Miner under center will give to Tyler Townsley.
Townsley
he just kind of leans forward, got hit hard, but he gets it out across the 5 up to the 7. We'll give him about 2 yards there.
Hey, Gawant to run stop for the Hawks.
And today's game, by the way, being brought to you on Bear Country 95.3 by McLaughlin Paving, Hubert Heating and Cooling, Jindal Auto Parts, your local CarQuest dealer, Hubie's Tavern and Restaurant, Tusco Trailer Repair, the Taylor Agency, and Leon's Auto Repair. Second down and 8 for Greenfield. Backs in the I formation, wide outs to either side. Miner calls the signals, hands the Bird up the middle. Not too much there, but he got up to the 5, up to the 10 rather. Give him about a yard or 2 there. It'll be third down and long for Greenfield. Actually, they're gonna spot him a little bit across, so.
Third and 6 for the Green Wave.
We'll call it 6 yards.
Townsley had his first carry up, took a grab of timeout on the field.
Actually, yep, looks like the quarter just ran out. End of the first quarter here, all Redhawks, and that's putting it mildly, folks. Our score on the CarQuest of Greenfield, South Deerfield, and Shelburne scoreboard, Frontier 26, Greenfield nothing. The second quarter next on Bear Country 95.3. Sean Hubert. Our studio producer is Matt Gregory. Redhawks putting up 26 on the wave. They scored on all four of their drives, and they have limited Greenfield to, in essence, nothing on their side of the ball. No first downs.
Yeah, essentially nothing. I mean, Tyler Miner, one for one passing. That was minus a yard. He ran a ball for three. And other than that, it was Townsley, one carry, a couple yards, and R.J. Bird, they're just bottling him up. Six carries, 13 yards, and of course he had that fumble at the end of his biggest yard. A nice 12-yard gain, but then fumbled the ball. So, yeah, just not much going right now for the Green Wave.
And they are faced with a third and six on their own 10-yard line as we begin play here in the second quarter. Greenfield now will be moving left to right. That's south to north. Frontier will be moving from north to south, right to left, towards the scoreboard side here at Frontier Regional. Now Greenfield trying to get something going and not get too discouraged, but it's hard not to when the other team is basically having their way with you. All right, they come out again, that pro set, I formation, wideouts to either side. And they go back to Townsley up the middle on third down for a short gain. From the 10 to about the 12, it'll be fourth in about four for Greenfield.
Townsley was the featured back last week against Turner's Falls with R.J. Bird out of that game. 16 carries, 52 yards, so those were the most carries he'd had on the season and the most yards as well. He had 50 yards against Belchertown, 184 on the season before today started for Tyler Townsley.
Miner to boot it. He is standing on the goal line. He'll hit it at around the 5-yard line. Worthley back near midfield. Frontier will get another good field position here. Here they come after him again. He is able to boot it away, and it rolls past Worthley. He picks it up at the 48 and just falls on it right there. And that is where the Red Hawks will begin their next drive in Greenfield territory.
Yeah, a bit of a late hit there, and I can see where the Red Hawks were looking for the flag, but you can kind of see where the kid eased up a little bit as he came in. It was a bit late, but the intent certainly was not there.
48-yard line of Greenfield. First down and 10 for Frontier. They've had touchdowns by Freeman to Cole Price. Freeman on the run. Landry on the one, and scored again. And then, of course, the one made conversion was by the quarterback Freeman. And the give up the middle, it goes to Landry, makes a cut to the outside, and he is off to the races. 10-5 touchdown. 48-yard touchdown run by Aaron Landry. It is 32-0.
Just talking about Miles Freeman's day. A couple of passes, a couple of touchdowns, a couple of runs, a couple of touchdowns. Aaron Landry, four carries, 91 yards, and a pair of touchdowns. Frontier extends their lead 32-0. Right at the beginning of the second quarter. Wow, they scored a lot of points last week, 66.
They're pacing for much more than that here.
20.
And Freeman, off play action, throws right side of the corner of the end zone. No good, trying to get it over there. And could not quite hook up with Joe Morosky. We'll take another timeout here. 10 minutes to play here in the first half. Our score now on the Carquest of Greenfield, South Deerfield, and Shelburne scoreboard. Frontier 32, Greenfield nothing. All right, Frontier's Blight set to boot it from the 40. Bird back deep again for Greenfield, high end over end. And it's taken by Jackson Pelletier along the right hash mark and brings it for a nice return out to the 43, 44-yard line. The ball's been in Greenfield's end the entire afternoon so far. We'll see if they can get something going here. They are going to almost assuredly end up on the wrong end of the scoreboard here, but they'd like to at least get something going offensively. But it's amazing, Sean, what's happened to this Greenfield defense. So a week after holding a very good Turner's team, very good Turner's offense to 8 points, they had Turner shut out until there were 7 minutes left in that fourth quarter, and look what's happened here. They've been just shredded here today.
Yeah, and I like this defense against Mahar when we saw it there too, but yeah, today, oh boy.
R.J. Bird ran right into Cade Gawanter, as that hole just completely blocked up on him. He gets dropped for a loss of one. Second down and 11. Boy, RJ just ran, and there was a big red shirt right in front of him.
We were talking about Brandon Bryant in the broadcast last night, and that looked like a Bryant pancake right there. We saw a few of those through the years, and RJ Bird just looking for the hole, goes through, and bam, hits a brick wall.
Second down and 11. Ball back at the 43-yard line. Miner barking out the signals out of the I formation. He'll give to Bird on the right side. It's a nice gain that time, but again, the hole closes up and they spin RJ down.
Freeman on a stop for Frontier.
And Miles Freeman among those on the stop. He brought the ball just about to midfield.
Gain of six, third and five from the 50-yard line.
Third down and five for Greenfield. And if there ever was a football team that needed to move the chain right now, that would be Greenfield right now. They need to somehow get this drive going here.
Yeah, no first downs yet for the Green Wave, and down by 32. We've got 8:35 to play in the second quarter. So you're right, now it's just about working hard and just trying to do something positive.
On third down, Miner will drop back the pass. Heavy rush, quick pass. It is caught by Rodriguez. They have the first down.
Miner's pass.
He brings it down to the 40-yard line. And there's the first down of the afternoon for Greenfield.
Yeah, Tyler Miner had completed his first pass, but it was a screen. It went for a minus yard.
A
nice little toss there. Nice job getting to the first down marker for the ball now at the Frontier Redhawk 41-yard line. Miner 2-for-2 passing, 9 yards now.
Now that's what this will be now, the rest of this game for Greenfield, is just executing some plays and not having them get blown up as they have been so far this afternoon.
Yeah, hopefully score some points, absolutely.
High formation, wide outs either side. Miner gives to Bird on the right side, cuts it in, cuts it back to the outside, written down after a gain of about four or five there.
42.
Second down, a flag comes in late.
Morosky on a stop, flag on a play.
Well, there's got to be some frustration building unless they're going to call that against the Red Hawks. Oh, they are. I thought that might have gone against the Green Wave, but I didn't see it. Must have been possibly the verbal variety.
Well, we're not down there. We don't know what happened. Sometimes someone does or says something, and then when you're the retaliator, you're the one that gets flagged. I'm not saying that's what happened here. But I've seen that happen a lot. But the ball now brought down to the 21-yard line of Frontier, and that's the second first down of Greenfield. They got one through the air and one via the penalty. And they're almost in the red zone.
First penalty of the game, and yeah, right. So whatever you need to do to extend that drive, and so Greenfield's now strung a couple of first downs together. They're in good position at the 22-yard line of Frontier.
20-yard line.
Out of the I formation, they go to the fullback, Tyler Townsley, up the middle, inside the 20. Spotted down at the 19, we'll give him two. Second down and eight coming up. We're down to 7 minutes to play here in the first half. Frontier 32, Greenfield nothing. The Greenfield Savings Bank halftime report is coming up.
32 points on 15 offensive plays for the Redhawks in this first quarter and a half or so. Just dominant.
From the Frontier 19, so Greenfield officially in the red zone. Let's see if they can convert. They go to Bird on the left side. Bounces it to the outside. Nothing there. Frontier was able to string that out, and Bird, as fast as he is, had nowhere to go.
No, tried to bounce it in. Couldn't get there. Tried to bounce it out. By then, there were 3-4 Red Hawks in pursuit. He's going to lose those 2 yards he just gained back to the line of scrimmage. So third and 10 at the 21-yard line for Greenfield.
Third and 10 from the Hawk 20-yard line.
And as you said, Jeff, just trying to string together some positive yards, some first downs. Again, knocking one in the end zone here. Moral victories along the way. 32-0 Frontier. Quarter and a half of this game.
High formation. And again, wide outs either side. Miner will drop back to pass, rolling to the right, heavy rush, tucks it under, lets it go towards the end zone, has a man down there. It is caught by Phelps. No, it bounced out at the end. Would have been good for six. It is fourth down now. And Greenfield, I'm sure, will go here at this point.
Leonard had two receivers. There were two defenders, and the ball was kind of floated right in the middle of the pack. Could have been a touchdown, could have been an interception. It ended up just being an incompletion for Miner. Yeah, you got to go here if you're Greenfield.
Yeah, a punt does no good at all. They will bring in Colin Kasuda, who will check in for Phelps. Owen Phelps, just a sophomore. Kasuda, one of the rare seniors. Miner, the quarterback, is a senior. And Townsley is a senior. La Santiago, a senior. And that's it. Jesus Rodriguez, also a senior. Everybody else is an underclassman. All right, fourth down and 10 from just outside the 20. Miner with the back split behind him. And he'll take a straight drop, steps up, throws it down towards Kasuda, back into the end zone. Incomplete, off his hands. Couldn't quite corral it. Would have been good for six. Instead, the wave turns it over on down.
Yeah, two straight shots into the end zone for Tyler Miner, and both of those balls could have been caught. That one there floated just a little bit at the end, made it a little bit more difficult. Coverage was just behind him and not able to come up with a catch, so Miner ends up 2 of 4 passing for 9 yards in this game, and two shots at the end zone. Green Wave not able to knock it in. Put it over on downs.
All right, so now Frontier will have it at their own 21-yard line, leading 32-0 with 5:20 to play here in the second quarter.
Redhawks have scored every time they've touched the football in this game, including the very first play of the game.
And they usually haven't taken all that long to do it.
Nope.
Landry has had just one hell of an afternoon so far. They're going to go up the middle. Seth Galanter from the 21 to the 25, a quick gain of 4, second and 6 coming up.
Well, again, talk about how scary good this offense is for Frontier. Galanter never got started until the second half last week.
That's right, and he had a good game.
Oh, he ended up with over 100 yards, after 148 of them, actually, and 8 carries for those 148.
Well, Galanter will be gone next year, but Landry will be back, Wordley will be back. And up the middle, it goes to Landry again. Gets a downfield block. He's to midfield. He could go again. Left sideline, 20, 10, 5. Touchdown. Colin Kasuda was in pursuit, trying to trip him up at the end. Couldn't do it. 75-yard touchdown run for Aaron Landry.
176 yards on 5 carries with 3 touchdowns. For Aaron Landry, he tore it up last week at Tech, and he's doing it again today at home against Greenfield. 38.
Wow.
And with what, 4 missed extra point conversions? Were there 4 missed 2-point conversions by the Redhawks?
They have the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. They've scored 6 touchdowns. They're
2-point conversion.
They're 1 for 5 so far. Quick pass, batted down, and then it was caught.
Oh boy, that
by
might go
Wordley
in.
On the deflection, leans in, and he got
he
in.
Did. Wow.
The ball was deflected at the line of scrimmage. Wordley caught it and somehow was able to sneak into the end zone, and the 2-point conversion
is going your way.
Timeout on the field. 4:36 to play here in the first half on the CarQuest of Greenfield. South Deerfield and Shelburne scoreboard. It's now Frontier 40, Greenfield nothing. Hubert again, his foot, like last week, getting a workout. Comes to Jackson Pelletier at the 25, right hash mark. Jackson out across the 40, up to the 44, 45-yard line. First and 10 there for Greenfield. Well, last Saturday afternoon over at the Tech school, it was Frontier 50, Tech 6 at halftime. We have a similar situation here with 4:30 to play, 40-0 Frontier. They're winning games and they're putting it away in a hurry. Timeout on the field taken by Frontier. We'll take the break. We'll be back with more football action from South Deerfield right after these on Bear Country 95.3. Well, coming up next Friday night, we'll be back with you again from Turner's Falls High School. The Turner's Falls Indians taking on the Franklin Tech Eagles. Franklin Tech, you know, they started the year playing against some Eastern Mass competition. They beat Mohawk, and now they've been playing the iron of the Intercounty League lately, as they played Frontier at home last week. They lost decisively to Athol, which appears to be one of the upper echelon teams this year as well, and then they get Turner's Falls. So no rest for the weary over there on Industrial Boulevard.
Yeah, Turner's Falls finishes up their schedule with Tech at Athol and then at Frontier, and that's kind of the game we're eyeballing right now.
Yeah, Turner's Frontier. I don't pretend to know who wins that one. All I know is that two great offenses will be going toe-to-toe. R.J. Bird on first down, bounces to the outside. Nice run for R.J. up near the first down marker.
Knocked out of bounds by number 10.
And let's see, they're going to give him a gain of about 11. First down and 10 for the way.
Yeah, how much fun was that last night? The Indians with the big lead, and they put Marcus Sanders in the game. Marcus, just a freshman. Jalen's little brother rips one for 70-some-odd yards and a touchdown. It was just a flash. He was down the field. Fun to watch that kid score his first touchdown. And the Indians just rolled in the second half of that one.
Yeah, you know, we have some seasons, Sean, where points are at a premium, and then there's the years where we really get to practice our touchdown calls.
And a lot of points, yeah.
This year is one of them. And I've noticed up and down the valley, we've had a lot of scoring. Tyler Townsley on first down. Nice carry for him. Four momentum will give him about four. Second down and six. But these Frontier dudes.
Steve Wortley on a stop.
I mean, Townsley is no little punk out there. He's a solidly built kid, but these Frontier guys just tee off on
him. Four carries, 10 yards for Tyler Townsley. So, yeah, having a tough go of it here. Again, it's the team speed is there. And, again, much like Turner's Falls, they've got team speed. But the Redhawks, they've got size, too. And they're quick, and they're fast, and they're big. And right now, a very scary football team.
Clock in motion, 3:17 to play here in the first half. Frontier 40, Greenfield nothing. The Wave with two first downs on the day, looking to get into the end zone before halftime. They'll give to Bird on the left side. RJ cuts to the outside, gets tripped up, and he brings it right around the 36-yard line or so. It'll be third down and short for the Wave.
Bird starting to gain some numbers here, 38 yards, taking him 12 carries to get those. Just a tad over 3 yards a carry, R.J. Bird. A lot of times stopped in the backfield today, though. A lot of negative runs, keeping that total down.
Well, in advance of that Turner's Frontier game, I'm going to try not to give either team any bulletin board material. There is precedent. I haven't done it very often, but I did do it. I remember in 1992. I'll get to that in a minute.
Yeah, I remember that.
The bus stop comment.
Yeah, big poster in the locker room.
I'll share the story. I felt like a goofball. They give to Bird up the middle, and he gets stacked up at the line of scrimmage. Looked like he had a little bit of a seam to get the first. Instead, they'll only give him about a half a yard. It'll be fourth down and about a yard.
No gain on the play.
They need to get to the 35-yard line.
Tell the bus stop story.
Well, we got to wait. It's fourth down here.
All right.
Critical play here.
I want to hear it.
With 2 minutes to play, 40 to nothing.
There's your head, I think, on a buzzsaw, right? Wasn't there a likeness of you?
Woo, I don't know.
And there was a buzzsaw.
I don't know how. Oh boy, I don't remember that. Yeah, that's a little disturbing.
No,
actually.
Maybe you didn't see that part.
Oh no.
Right around Halloween, right?
It's before Thanksgiving.
Oh, all right.
Before the Turkey Day game. High formation, fourth and one. They go to Bird, nothing doing. I mean, as soon as he got the handoff, Seth Gawanter wrapped him up. Seth blasted through. I think Seth knew right where the play was going.
He had to have, because he just went right from the spot to R.J. Bird 5 yards deep and took him down.
Nowhere to go for Mr. Bird there. So it's 1992, and we were getting close to the Turkey Day game at Greenfield. Greenfield and Turner's was great that year, and they ultimately went to the Division II Super Bowl. Greenfield was a good team as well, but that was one of the days when they were in the Suburban League, and they had a few losses during the year, and they were not part of the postseason picture. Freeman back to pass. He'll throw over the middle. A flag comes in. It's caught by Borowski into Greenfield territory, still going, and he's run out of bounds inside the 30-yard line, but we're going to see about the flag. It's a hold against Frontier, so this one's coming back.
Yeah, it'll be a 30-yard pass play. Freeman already 2-for-2 passing, but that's going to come back. Second penalty of the game against Frontier.
So Greenfield had a very good football team that year, but they played really tough competition back then. Greenfield had a much bigger school population back then. And Turner's Falls was the winner of the Inter-County League. And on the air, I had said to you, we're getting ready for Turkey Day. Greenfield had a good year this year. They got some really good players, but boy, they are heading into a buzzsaw with that Turner's Falls team. And it got back to the Greenfield kids, and Greenfield ended up winning the Turkey Day game. Very tough physical game, as I recall, 12-0. And that was their, that basically was their Super Bowl, because Turner's Falls went on to play in the D2 Super Bowl a week and 2 days later. But that basically was Greenfield's Super Bowl, and they did. They had a drawing of me and the buzzsaw. And
it wasn't pretty.
I never want to be that guy, a media member who provides bulletin board material for either team.
I didn't think it was that bad, but they took that and used that as motivation, and it worked.
And it worked that day. Stephen Worthley will give it right back to the quarterback, Freeman. Greenfield waiting for him, and Freeman leans forward and gains a couple of yards out to the 32-yard line. They keep the clock going. A minute left down here in the second quarter. And Hazleton then goes on the stop.
First carry by Freeman that didn't go into the end zone. Freeman had two carries,
right.
8 yards and two touchdowns on the ground.
Frontier's going to call a TO. This will be a quick 30. We will keep it here.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, I looking at both of these teams, I was really curious to see the matchup with this Greenfield defense, if they could stop the Redhawk offense. Clearly unable to today. I've got to give, if they played right now, I've got to give the nod to the Redhawks.
Oh, bulletin board material. Bulletin board. Give the edge, okay.
The nod. It was a nod. It wasn't even a no. It wasn't an edge. I didn't put a line on it.
Well, actually, Sean,
the edge.
There's still a few weeks between that showdown.
Yeah, a couple weeks to go.
Stephen Worthley, now Greenfield stacks him up. Greenfield's starting to kind of get a little sick of getting pushed around now. Now we're starting to see the Greenfield team that we saw last week. No gain, third and long.
Third and 18. Pretty safe play calling here as well.
Yeah. 25 seconds left, so Frontier, I think they still have to run one play here. Greenfield Savings Bank halftime report coming up. We'll talk more about this at halftime, but actually, Sean, I'm kind of pushing you on a limb. I will join you on that limb. If someone had to ask me right now who wins that game, I would say Frontier.
You got to lean that way right now.
Stephen Worthley with a short gain over the right side, and looks like that will do it. And that'll do it. End of the first half, and what a first half for a second consecutive week. A huge offensive performance by the Frontier Redhawks. Our score at halftime on the conquest of Greenfield South Deerfield and Shelburne scoreboard. It's Frontier 40, Greenfield nothing. The Greenfield Savings Bank High School Football Halftime Report is coming up next.
Okay, we're going to be entertained by the Redhawk fans. Good afternoon, Redhawk fans. It's now time for our halftime entertainment presenting the Redhawk Sound of the Frontier Regional Band. The band is under the direction of Mr. Max Sherrill. We're going to open a show with famous tunes by the 70s horn rock band Chicago. Every band student, young or old, should know and love this song. Here's the 70 classic, 25 or 64.
Welcome to the Greenfield Savings Bank High School Football Halftime Report. We are in South Deerfield today. Jeff Tirrell, Sean Hubert. Studio producer is Matt Gregory. 40-0 Frontier at halftime. Now, this is the second consecutive week on a Saturday afternoon we have seen these Frontier Redhawks running up and down the field. Sean, to say that they are impressive offensively is understating it.
Well, you know, we knew Greenfield coming in here, and again, look around, man. It's Booster Day. The sun's trying to come out. Everybody's smiling. Dave Planchette's up here kissing babies. I mean, everybody's happy, and it's all is good in South Deerfield right now for the Redhawks, really. It's just, again, a team that we've historically talked about as a defensive team, and they always have been. They hit hard. They play good defense. They went to some Super Bowls on the backs of their defense. This is just a totally different look for this team, and again, unstoppable. Franklin Tech, again, that defense is not a terrible defense. They shut out Mohawk, and Mohawk's not a terrible team. But then to have Frontier come and do what they did, again, this was going to be a marker for me. And the Redhawks just blew right past it.
And the Greenfield Green Wave a week ago in enemy territory, right, they hold that Turner Stahl's offense, which is unbelievably prolific as well. They kept them with a zero on the scoreboard until there were 7 minutes left in the game. Greenfield nearly was able to steal that on the road before finally the touchdown pass to Croteau ends up winning it for the Turner's Falls Indians. And now look what happens here.
Yeah, it was a struggle. And again, R.J. Bird was out last week against Turner's. We thought that that would make a big difference for their offense. He's been the workhorse, 14 carries, but just 33 yards. So, you know, again, running the ball against this defense versus running it against the Turner's defense, I think Bird may have had a little bit more success. Could have been a difference maker there, but he wasn't there. The game was played as it was, and Greenfield, again, with a great defensive effort. They haven't been up 40 points, I don't think, in all three games, have they? And now they've been up 40 here in the first half.
That's right, yeah.
So, again, that just speaks to the Redhawk offense, how prolific they are, how good they are, how deep they are, fast. Again, big. This is really one of the better teams that I've seen in the league in many years, I would say. As far as just being well-rounded and depth and experience, and just this is a solid football club, no doubt.
And to add to the talent, they also have a little bit of that Frontier mean streak as well, which doesn't hurt.
They hit hard. They always have. Again, defensively, they're going to make you pay for the yards you get. And they're not getting many right here against them today. Greenfield is not.
40-0 Frontier here at halftime. The Frontier marching band entertaining the crowd. They just did Chicago 25-6-4. Now they're doing a little X's and O's out there on the field. Great job by them. Booster day here in South Deerfield. Frontier 40, Greenfield nothing. We will take a timeout. More Greenfield Savings Bank High School football halftime report coming up next on Bear Country 95.3.
The third tune this afternoon is another great tune from the 2010s. This song is by the pop funk band Fall Out Boy and features a melody from the Munsters TV show. Here's this song, Uma Thurman. Opportunity to recognize three amazing band seniors, Joe Morosky, Billy Prunier, and Melissa Shaw. Joe's with the football team getting ready for the second half, but they invite Billy and Melissa to come forward to receive their senior band cakes, a signal of their awesome achievement as members of the Frontier Band for many years. Congratulations, Joe, Billy, and Melissa. Thank you to Joe, Billy, and Melissa for your years of dedicated service to the Redhawk Band. The final number today, the band jumps back to the funkiest decade, the 70s, made famous by the Motown group, the Commodores. Here's a groove that everybody can get down and sing along to. Here's Brick House. For the Redhawk Band under the direction of Max Sherrill. Nice job, band. Here come the Redhawks.
Thus 40-0 in favor of Frontier, Aaron Landry with just a huge, he had almost a season in just one half.
Yeah, well again, last week he did pretty much the same thing. What do you have last week? Landry, 6 carries, 131 yards here in the first half against Greenfield. 5 carries, 176 yards, and they hit the trifecta on the end zone. 3 touchdowns as well. Oh, scary good.
Greenfield will be receiving the second half kickoff here. R.J. Bird is standing back at the 5-yard line. In front of him, Jackson Pelletier and Tyler Townsley. Nate Hazelton, Jared Hart, Jesus Rodriguez out there as well. Those are all the deep men for Greenfield. And item one for Greenfield was met in the first half. They finally got that first down. They got it into the red zone. Item two is to score. And it goes by Bird again, down to the 11, picks it up, heads up field, cuts to the outside, and a swarm of red bringing him down. He's trying to get away, yeah. Spun down back inside the 10-yard line. As he has had trouble fielding the football, the ball has been bouncing around like crazy on him. And by the time he's been able to corral it, the Red Hawks have been bearing right down on him.
Well, we've seen that sometimes where you fumble the ball back there a little bit. It throws the timing of the special teams off, and you find a seam and you're gone. But not with this Red Hawk special teams. They're just too quick, and Bird ended up fielding the ball, and then it got spun around and ended up losing some yards back inside the 10-yard line to start this opening drive in the second half.
9-yard line. So they've lost the battle on the scoreboard. They've lost the battle in field position. The ball has been in their end virtually the entire afternoon. They had that one drive when they got down to the 19. And they ultimately turned it over on downs. First half carry goes to R.J. Bird. Ball pops out. Frontier says they have it. They do. Bird got popped. The ball popped out. 6-yard line. And you talk about a short field that the Red Hawks will be dealing with. That's what they have right now.
Well, again, what Greenfield needed there was to get the ball and go on a decent drive. Like you said, a couple of first downs, eat up a little clock, maybe get one into the end zone there. And instead, the first carry by Birdie gets spun around. The ball flew out in the Red Hawks. Second fumble on the afternoon by Bird. First and goal for their opening possession of the second half. Like they needed that, up 40 to nothing for the Red Hawks.
6 yard line of Greenfield. And their defense right now back out there again, trying to somehow dig in.
Gotta give this one to DeWanter, huh?
Yeah, Seth, the fullback right now. Oh. This play is whistled dead. It was going to Landry. He's already been in there three times today. And it's a false start of the Hawks. That'll mark him back to the 11. And it'll be second and goal from there.
Well, I guess if you're looking to pick nits, you can say that they've been penalized three times for 30 yards, but pretty irrelevant stat at this point.
Yeah, in this game it is. However, you know, most good coaching staffs, and Don Gordon, of course, has a good staff there. The former coach, Scott Dredge, is on the coaching staff as well. He's got the headset on down there. He used to be the head coach here. Now he's one of Gordon's assistants. So, yeah, he, in a game against a tough opponent, that would be a strong consideration. Into the game now for Frontier is Dalton DeForest, a senior running back, backup running back, and he will take it.
Last San Diego on a stop.
Take it from maybe a yard down to the 10. It'll be second and goal from there. So we're going to see the Red Hawks sprinkle in some fresh bodies here.
Red Hawks parents, thank you again for your generous support.
Wholesale changes last week, late in the game against Franklin Tech. The offense struggled a little bit, the second team offense, but the second team defense was pretty good.
It's DeForest again. He has it on the left side. Greenfield's able to stack him up. And they bring him down after, we're going to say no gain here. So it's still on the 10. Third and goal from there. So Red Hawks getting a little bit bogged down here.
They're taking their foot off the pedal just a little bit too. Again, running back in there. Running him a couple of times on first and second. Now it's third and goal for the Hawks.
Frontier will be at Athol next Friday night. That's their next game, so that'll be a good gauge as to where they really are.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's DeForest again up the middle. There was a hole there, but then it closed up. The ball popped out, but they're going to say he was stacked up before that. Greenfield pounced on the loose ball, but instead it'll be fourth down now for the Hawks. I'm not sure if they have anyone who can kick, but in a game like this, this is where you, if you have a kicker, you might think about trying to convert because you might need that in a big game, kind of let you know where you are in a game situation. They're going to want to play here, though.
Get DeForest another yard on that, so three carries, 3 yards for him.
Matt Hildreth, the backup quarterback under center, gives to DeForest again up the middle, keeps the legs chugging, still going. Did not get into the end zone, however. Got down to about the 5 yard line. So three plays for 5 yards,
or
four plays for 5 yards, and Greenfield will take over on their own 5 yard line. So basically, they're right about where they were when the half began.
Well, I remember that Super Bowl game, Turner's Falls, and again, it was looking to be a lopsided loss, and the opposing coach took a knee in the third quarter, about halfway through the third quarter. And,
I
remember the kids and the staff, and they kind of took that as an insult. That was about the next best thing right there. They just took a kid off the bench that didn't get to play much, run him four straight times and see what he can do.
And the gift to R.J. Bird on the right side, turns the corner and keeps the legs moving. He's run out of bounds on the far side of the field.
Matt Hildreth
needed to get to the 15 for the first. We'll see how close he got. Looking at it from an angle, he got close to the first down, but not quite there. It'll be second down and two. We'll give him 8 yards there. 7:30 to play here, third quarter. All Frontier. Red Hawks leading 40 to nothing. This one was over shortly after it began.
Yeah, Greenfield went three and out on their first possession. The Red Hawks' first play of the game was a 62-yard touchdown throw by Miles Freeman to Cole Price. Hit him again later in that quarter as well.
Out of the eye, they go to the fullback. No, that's not Tyler Townsley. That was Bird again.
Tyler Townsley on a carry.
And we will see how close he got. It is a first down.
Very good for a Greenway first down.
Brings it across the 15 to the 16-yard line. And a fresh set of downs.
17 carries now for R.J. Bird. 43 yards in the game. And again, caught in the backfield several times.
First and 10, Greenfield.
Red Hawk defense comes as advertised, and the offense is even better.
I formation behind Tyler Meyer. The give is to the fullback, Townsley. He'll take it from the 16 to the 19. We'll give him three there.
Pat McGranahan on a stop.
Second down and seven.
2 yard gain, second and eight.
Puck in motion, 6:50 to play third quarter. Frontier 40, Greenfield zip. Patriots Browns tomorrow starting at 10 with the pregame. And 1 o'clock kickoff.
I think Tom Brady already threw a touchdown. Pats are already up 7.
Well, in it. Boy, Sean, I don't know. We'll be on the air Friday night from Turner's Falls. I might have to call you out a little bit.
It's going to be ugly.
Miner back to pass, overthrew the intended receiver, Black. Nate Hazelton, and then Miner got dumped at the end of the play by Cade Gawanter.
Personal foul, roughing the passer.
Roughing the passer, so that'll be a 15-yard penalty, and that'll take it from the 19-yard line up to about the 34.
That's at least the second first down Greenfield's received via the penalty from the Red Hawks. Four penalties now, 45 yards against the Hawks. Greenfield has not committed a penalty in this game so far.
Which actually surprises me, because the way that the Frontier defensive line and linebackers were coming rushing through, I figured there'd be at least a few holds in there.
Yeah, I usually try to slow them up, and that's one way to do it. But
well, maybe they should have.
Yeah, I mean, again, a hold here, a hold there if you can get away with it, but that wouldn't have been enough either.
I've heard ex-players say that if the officials called every hold that they saw, they'd be holding on virtually every play in the NFL.
That. Absolutely.
As the players have gotten bigger, stronger, and faster, the defenders I'm talking about, that offensive lineman, oftentimes they have little choice but to hold. R.J. Bird with a quick spurt, right side,
Bird.
Down the right sideline, turns on the afterburners, and R.J. Bird
Greenway.
Is going to take it, 66 yards,
66
touchdown Greenfield.
Yeah, just like that, the numbers look a lot better for R.J. Bird. He has that kind of explosiveness. He's not been able to get outside the tackles. Best run by Bird. 18 carries, 109 yards now. He does have a pair of fumbles, but now he has a touchdown run as well. Fourth touchdown of the season for Bird at three against Mahar.
To 2-point conversion.
And it's looking like it's mostly backups out there for Frontier defensively. Frontier 40, Greenfield 6. The Wave will go for two. Backs are split behind Miner. They usually pass out of the T formation here. Miner will take a quick drop, throws. Incomplete, looking for Rodriguez on a little slant in. The conversion is no good. We'll take a timeout. 5:07 to play third quarter. Our score on the Carquest of Greenfield, South Deerfield, and Shelburne scoreboard. It's now Frontier 40, Greenfield 6.
Tyler Townsley to kick off for Greenfield. Edo McMillian back for the Redhawks.
All right, so Greenfield kicking off for the first time since the opening kickoff. After Greenfield gets on the board, that goose egg is off. 40-6 now in favor of Frontier. And here comes the kick, it is topped. And it is taken by Wordley. His knee goes down at the 32-yard line.
At the Red Hawks 30-yard line.
Now the
Red
Hawks will come out.
First and 10.
And it looks like it will be Hildreth out there again at quarterback. This is great because Matt Hildreth, he'll be presumably, he's the presumptive starting quarterback next year, as Miles Freeman, one of the senior captains, will be graduating in the spring. So this is good. I mean, reps in a varsity game against the number one Greenfield defense. That's, you know, their starters are out there.
That is invaluable experience.
Absolutely. So this is good. Worked out perfectly for Frontier. They got the big lead, and now they can, well, they got Seth Gawanter out there at fullback. And it is Seth up the middle.
Seth Gawanter on the
carry. Quick hitter up the middle, and a gain of about 8 or 9 right there. Or did they move the chain? Let's see. Now it's a first down carry.
Matt Griswold on the stop for the Green Wave.
Just previous to that play, if I had said to you that Seth Gawanter had 2 carries for 5 yards, how the Redhawks doing? But he has now has 3 carries for 15, and they're doing just fine.
When you have a moment, Sean, I want to look at what you had for some of the Turner stats versus Greenfield. I know they only scored the 8 points, and I know they, a lot of the guys did get their yardage.
Gawanter on a carry.
Gawanter got stood up at the line of scrimmage. Dylan, not a lot of gain there.
Too close on the stop.
And if you have that.
Yeah,
Sean's
I got a
through
rifle
notes.
Through my stuff here. I don't carry as much with me as I used to, but.
Colin Cooter on the stop for the Green Wave, 58.
Hey, we don't have that.
There it is, right there. Let's see the Indians. 10
for the Redhawks.
Deion Brown, 3 of 8 passing, 63 yards.
And the type of the game winning touchdown.
Yep. Quinn Doyle, 28 carries, about 125 yards.
That's so, going to run a carry.
Far fewer carries than Bird here today. 18 carries he has so far for 109. Of course, the big one there. Craver had 22 yards. On 6 carries.
On the stop for the Wave.
That was Jack's first game back. Jack
Carring
had
just
a couple carries and that one for 12.
Jack looked good last night, I will tell you that.
Yep,
they all looked good.
Put up a 54 spot against Mahar. But right now, the combined score of the 2 games broadcast this weekend is 94-18.
Ouch.
You like big numbers, I guess. It's good football.
3rd down and 4. Hildreth back to pass. It's a designed run, and he's going to be dropped down. The ball pops loose. Greenfield gets it on the fumble.
They're
going to say incomplete pass. No fumble. Yeah, that was definitely not a pass. Hildreth got kind of spun down by one arm, and he coughed up the ball. So Greenfield gets it back at around the 42-yard line of Frontier.
Yeah, tucking in his shoulder pad there. You can see, yeah, he got, as you said, spun around. Not a big kid. And one of those big guys that had him, whipped him down, and the ball flew out. Greenfield will take possession at the Frontier 43-yard line.
3 minutes to play here in the third quarter. Clock now back in motion. Frontier 40, Greenfield 6. Bird just scored from 66 yards. Their last drive and showed tremendous foot speed. Again, it just demonstrates that if he has the ability to find the hole or find a seam or find some air, he can pick them up and put them down.
Okay.
Timeout called by
Greenfield. Looks like this will be just a quick 30-second break. We'll keep it here at the field.
So very much like last weekend at Franklin Tech, we saw Frontier build the big lead. They put in the JV squad, and then Franklin Tech battled back a little bit. We saw the starters come back into that game.
Next game is next Friday night.
Right now we've got a 20-6 score.
We'll
see if Burke can rip another one here. See if we get some of those Redhawks starters back into the game just to make sure.
Backs are split behind Minor. Again, Greenfield almost always passes here. They cannot quick pass down to Kasuda. Colin has it inside the 20-yard line. It'll be a first down for the Wave. Into the red zone. Just a quick hitter there. Nicely done by Tyler Minor.
3 of 5 passing is Minor. That Mahar game we had a couple weeks ago, Tyler Minor did not throw a single pass in that game.
Not a one.
Nope. 3 for 5 passing here. 35 yards for the senior Minor.
First and 10, Greenfield from the
2 minutes to play, third quarter.
15-yard line.
Frontier 40, Greenfield 6. The Wave has it. First and 10 from the Redhawk 15-yard line. Again, the backs are split behind Minor. No, they've gone to the eye. Looking for Bird here, potentially. They will go to RJ left side, and
RJ
he brings
Bird
it
on a carry.
Down to the 10-yard
Joe
line.
Hunter
quick gain of 5. It'll be second down and 5. Greenfield trying to get on the board one more time before the end of the third, make the scoreboard look a little more respectable.
Well, and Bird still kind of chasing 1,000 yards on the season. Even with the one game that he missed, he had 386 coming in and 114 here this afternoon. Up around 600
second
yards.
Second and 6 for the way from the Hawk 11-yard
total
line.
For RJ Bird.
Marty Brown brings him up. Call it 2nd and 6 from the 11. High formation behind Minor. There you go, Townsley this time. He got hit immediately. Tyler got pushed back after just a gain of about one. Down to the 10-yard line. Will be third down and five from the 10. Yeah, 1 minute to play in the third.
Tough for Townsley to find running room today. Six carries
for
him.
From
and
the
just
Redhawks
14 yards
line.
Total. Greenfield with a third down now. Third and five. Get back up to the 5-yard line for the first down.
See if they go back to the air here. See if Mike Kaczewski has a trick play that he wants to unveil here. High formation behind Miner. Third and five from the 10. The give to Bird. Right side. Has the first down inside the 5, down to the 4. It'll be first and goal for Greenfield. They'll stop the clock to reset the chain. 21 seconds left here in the third.
Darn near got there, just a little bit shy. 20 carries, 120 yards. Again, two fumbles, one touchdown. And let's see if it looks like the clock is going to run out on the third quarter before Greenfield gets this playoff. They're still in the huddle.
Yeah, they're just going to wait here. End of three here in South Deerfield. Booster Day at Frontier Regional. Our score on the conquest of Shelburne. South Deerfield and Greenfield scoreboard. It's Frontier 40, Greenfield 6. Fourth quarter action next on Your Country 95.3. First and goal for Greenfield from the Frontier 5-yard line. Let's begin fourth quarter action here. 40-6 in favor of Frontier. That could change, though, here. They give to Tyler Townsley. And he takes it in to the end zone. Touchdown. 5-yard TD run for Tyler Townsley. And it's now 40-12 with the extra points coming up.
Yep, tough day so far for Tyler Townsley. 7 carries, 19 yards. But that helps a little bit. He gets into the end zone. So nice job there by Tyler. I believe that would be his first rushing touchdown of the season.
I think you are correct, yes.
Yeah, so nice job there, kid. Tighten the score a little bit more, 40-12 now, and Greenfield will go for the two.
And they have Bird and Townsley split behind Miner. Two receivers, Rodriguez and Casuda, off on the left. Miner back to pass, throwing left corner of the end zone, looking for Casuda down there. Incomplete. And we will take another timeout. We'll step aside again. 10:55 to play here. Fourth quarter. Conquest of Greenfield, South Deerfield, and Shelburne scoreboard. Frontier 40 and Greenfield 12. Tyler Townsley set to boot it from the 40. Tops that one, and it's a free ball picked up by Frontier. Greenfield's coverage is there. They stack them up at the 40-yard line.
Kiernan Freeman on a return for the Hawks.
And it'll be first down and 10 for the Redhawks. And again, they'll send out that second team offense. Getting a lot of experience here. They'd love to get the ball in the end zone here.
Again, we saw this second string offense last week. Somewhere around the third quarter in that Franklin Tech game, and had a hard time on the exchange, really. There were a couple of one-play drives where they fumbled the snap and turned the ball over. We haven't seen that here from them so far today.
And on first down, they're going to give it to big Seth Gaunter.
Seth Gaunter on a carry.
Brings it out across the 45 to the 46. Quick gain of 6. Rodriguez on the stop for the wave. It'll be second down and 4.
Yeah, really been almost like a day off for Seth. 4 carries, 22 yards. Nice easy day for him. He had a lot of carries earlier in the season. 26 carries for 133 yards against East Hampton. So decreased workload for the last couple weeks for him.
Gawanter out and Corbin Blight is in. And the handoff center of the line to Yildiz.
I'll bring Yildiz on a carry.
And Yildiz brings it close to midfield, short of a first down. We'll call third and
on a stop. Oh, carry short
my mic
first
off.
Down, third and two for the Hawks.
Oh, I did mess up my mic. Oh, boy. Did I break it?
I can still hear you.
No, I know, but let's see here. Okay. I think we're good.
There you go. Stop touching it.
As I was saying, third down and two. The Diz comes in motion, but the inside give to DeForest, nothing doing. As Townsley, who just scored the touchdown, came through and brought him down. It'll be fourth down now for Frontier. We'll see if they just choose to go here or decide to send the punting unit out there.
Yeah, interesting call here. Maybe you just leave these guys out there and run the play on fourth and three. Try to get the first down. No, we're going to make some changes, so most likely they are going to punt this ball.
Yeah.
Looks like a punt, though. 8:49 to play, clock rolling here in the fourth, and again, the Redhawks built themselves a 40-point lead. They're cruising right now, 40-12, and they will punt this ball to Greenfield.
29, Stephen Worthley.
Oh, over the head.
And the snap goes over Worthley's head, and he's going to take off on the right side. And look at this. He's still going. Did he get the first down? Are you kidding me?
That's a long way to go to get it.
You got to be kidding me. Let's see where they marked him out. He needed to get to the 50.
He ran like 38 yards.
The snap went over the head of Worthley. It chased him back to close to the 20. And then he accelerated along the sideline. Where did the ball end up?
First down, they got it. First down, Hawks.
First down, Red Hawks.
You got to be kidding me.
You know, again, just the athleticism and the heads up. You know, again, that ball was snapped a good 2 feet over his head, and guys bearing down on him, able to get to the outside, and the foot speed. Again, Red Hawks are fast. Ball right at the 50.
I've never seen that.
No, not like that.
And nothing like that. I mean, that was just a disaster. And this play is going to be whistled dead. False start on the Red Hawks. He saw it a mile away, so that'll set him back 5 yards. Corbin Blight is back in there now. Last week, when we were calling his name for the first time, it was everything I could do to not call him Corbin Burnson. The only other Corbin that I know. Corbin Blight. They're both Corbin B. It's DeForest up the middle. Nice game for him. Belton had been mostly kept in short or negative yardage up until there, but he made back 4 of the yards, lost the penalty. He's second down and 11 from the 49.
Second and 11.
Down to 6:55 to play in the football game. Frontier 40, Greenfield 12.
Had a good laugh was a couple weeks ago at Turner's Falls where Mr. Roberts has been doing the PA there since 1965 or 66, somewhere around there.
Wow.
And he called Owen Ortiz David Ortiz
by mistake,
the crowd got a kick out of that. Of course, it was baseball season right then, and
little
poppy on the mind there.
Yildiz in the backfield gets swarmed under for no gain. It'll be third down and long. No, that's okay. You know, he's done it for such a long time.
So good at it still.
He's lost nothing off his fastball,
no,
for sure.
No. Again, as far as local guys go, that guy's been in that box a long, long time.
Longer than you and I.
Yeah, absolutely.
We've done it for a long time.
Absolutely, and still enjoys getting to the game and doing the ball games. And does a great job, Mr. Roberts does over there in Turner's Falls.
Third and 12.
Third down and 12. Yildiz comes in motion. Back to pass. Heavy rush. Gets away from now. Dumps it off. It is caught by Morosky. And Joe broke a tackle, brought it down to the Greenfield 45. It'll be fourth down and 5. And nicely executed play there by the Frontier backup offense. And Hildreth did a good field, so they'll give it a shot here. Hildreth looks over the green wave D, takes the snap, gives it to Yildiz up the middle, has the first down, tripped up. Oh man, if he had gotten Bass Minor, he may have been gone himself. First and 10 for the Hawks at the Greenfield 38.
Comes up on his right hip just a little bit, but a nice run there by the young man, and a first down for the Hawks. And clock still rolling now, just under 5 minutes to play in the game. Hawks, again, built a 40-point lead early, and they've been on cruise control ever since, 40-12 right now over the green wave.
And people may say, you know, what's the meaning of a long second half like this? Well, it's meaningful for both sides. Trust me on that one, especially for the Frontier offense here. Belton DeForest up the middle. Makes a nice gain inside the 35, down close to the 30-yard line. His finest run of the afternoon, down to 4:25 to play.
Oh, you're absolutely right about that, Jeff. Again, we saw this second string offense last week come into a blowout game, and they just didn't execute very well. And you can certainly see the difference between last week and this week. Moving the ball here. A completely new squad of guys out there, mostly.
And the pitch, Dalton DeForest up the middle, has the first down, still going. We got it. Well, let's see. It's close. But it looked like he got it by about a yard. We'll see.
Oh, a nice little drive here by the second string Red Hawk offense.
And the it was a first down. And the significance for Greenfield in the second half was that offense, even if it was against mostly the backups, to get into the end zone. Losing is tough. Losing where you put up a zero is very hard. It would have been their second consecutive shutout loss. Trust me, they'll take those 12 points on into next week.
Yeah, again, it makes you feel better. It looks better. And then, you know, you ran a couple of plays that worked well, and you can build off of that for sure.
First down and 10. Yildiz is up the middle. Ends up in the Greenfield secondary. Well, this offensive unit now is, they've kind of caught their stride here. Flag in. They'll stop the clock with 3:08 to play. But they're looking to get into the end zone again here. And again, the backup offense was not getting it done against Tech, and Coach Gordon had no choice but to put his main guys back in again.
That'll be the first penalty against Greenfield today. It's going to be a face mask, I think, a 15-yarder.
And it's going to bring it into the red zone down to the 10-yard line.
Yeah, again, yeah, these kids look a lot sharper this week. We're talking about the backup group of offense for the Red Hawks.
Now they're bringing in a whole new crew.
I think some of those kids just came out of the stands, actually. I don't even know that those kids were on the team when this game started. They got a whole third string now in there.
Yeah, everybody, virtually everybody got to play here today.
Fantastic. Booster day in front of a big crowd.
And the third string quarterback out there, Garrett DeForest, a freshman, has it a flag down.
Flag on a play.
And the running back there was Sam Hubert, a freshman, 5'8", 130. But we'll see about the flag. And it's going to go against the Red Hawks.
5-yard penalty.
So mark them back 5 yards. 2:38 to play. Our postgame show coming up. We will reveal our player of the game, brought to you by Bubs Barbecue, the music store, Attorney Leah Phillips, Academy Mortgage, CNA Repaired Equipment, and Kobe Hibachi Sushi Bar.
Ricky Craver was our player of the game last night for Turner's Falls at Mahar. Sitting down in the crowd with Deion Brown and Mikey Babcock, and they declined an interview. They said, no, coach probably wouldn't like it. They were keeping tight lips. Nothing to say to you guys.
And it's Hubert up the middle, gain of a couple. Back inside the 15 to the 13.
He really just wanted to go get a hot dog is what it was. I could see they were heading to the concession stand and go on the radio at halftime or go get my hot dog, and they chose the hot dog.
I will say this. Chris Collins and I had Tion on a post-game interview during basketball season. And very bright kid.
Yeah, good
Very bright kid.
Great Hubert on the carry.
He was very expansive with some of his answers. He didn't give me the really quick, you know, he gave it some thought. He gave me some really good answers.
I just can't think of a nicer kid than Tion Brown. And again, small in stature. We've talked about it through the years, but he's going to top out about 5'6", 5'7". But what a heart, what an athlete, what a great kid.
And slipping and falling as he was coming through there was number two, Ito McMillan, freshman running back. It'll be fourth down now. And the ball still outside the Greenfield 10. We come down to the 1 minute mark. Here comes the train.
Well, this really was the best thing that could happen in this fourth quarter. You know, again, you get a lot of experience. Oh, look at that thing. That thing's flying, huh? Amtrak.
Well, there's the Vermonter. Oh, that does go by fast.
Get in, get some experience, and score a few points, have some fun, and again, in front of a big crowd on Booster Day.
One more shot at it, fourth down, inside give, and that's not going to happen as the frontier runner McMillan is
Marty Brown on
hit
a stop
immediately
for the
by Marty Brown. 47 seconds left. Greenfield will get the ball back, and this one will soon be in the books. Want to take a moment here before we forget on the postgame show to thank our studio producer, Matt Gregory, and also Nick Danger. Last night they were both pinch hitting for Dave Reno. And those of you that listen to high school football with us, you know Dave's been with us for many, many years. And he.
Many games.
Yep. And it's always Dave. It's almost always Dave. It's rarely, if ever, anybody else. And when you have to pinch hit for somebody like that, it's a new thing. And Both guys did a great job, Matt. A marathon day. He was on the board when I was working the other side of the street for our other station, WHAI, with a live broadcast. Matt put in a very long day. We definitely appreciate his efforts here today.
Well, this is our 340th game as broadcast partners, and I'll bet you Dave Reno's done what? At least 320 of those games. He hasn't missed many, maybe 330.
Yeah, not many at all. Fumble on the play, big battle for the ball. Redhawks say they have it. And
second down.
The clock is still rolling.
So Greenfield will keep possession.
Must have held on, but.
And they'll just have time maybe for one more play, if that. We'll have our post-game show coming up. It's celebration time here in the South County. They get ready for Athol. Turner's gets ready for Tuck. And down the road, it'll be Turner's Falls versus Frontier. Will both teams still be undefeated at that time? We will know our answer. RJ Bird has it. And spun down for no gain, and that will do it. Final score here, a successful Booster Day, needless to say, for the Frontier Redhawks. They win it 40-12 over Greenfield on the conquest of Greenfield, South Deerfield, and Shelburne scoreboard. Stay tuned. The Bear Country High School Football postgame report coming up next on Bear Country 95.3. I like when they're shaking hands at the end of the game.
Oh, yeah.
Gawanter plays Legion ball
with
Miner and with somebody else from Greenfield.
Oh, yeah.
So Tion plays with, he plays Legion ball with Gawanter.
Yep.
And Townsley is the other one.
I announced a few of those games.
Yeah.
Yeah, I did a few of those this summer. So, I enjoy that. I enjoy seeing all the different kids.
Yeah.
Diamond was on that team, Julian Diamond.
Playing on the same team.
Yeah.
So it's kind of cool.
Yeah, Sharby.
Right, Julian Diamond and Gawanter are mortal enemies during football season, but now they're teammates.
Yeah, well, Brandon Bryant was on that team too.
Oh, that's right,
Welcome
to the Bear Country High School Football post-game report. Final score on Booster Day, a very successful one for the Frontier Redhawks as they defeated the Greenfield Greenway 40-12. Shawn, this one was over quite early. Frontier running out to a 40-0 halftime lead. They cruise home to victory from there. Again, just a very impressive team. We have focused on the offense, obviously, but they are a pretty complete team as well.
I was just thinking, between last week and this week, they've scored 90 points in four quarters. They put up a 50 spot in the first half against Franklin Tech and then 40 here today. So in four quarters of football, the first halves of two games, 90 points this offense has put up. So, again, traditionally we talk about the defense here. We know they hit hard. They play good D. But the offense is so good, too. So, again, it is the complete team. The special teams play well. I thought Greenfield would provide a little more resistance today than they did based on the games we had seen them play. But are the Redhawks that good or does Greenfield come in flat a little bit? I don't know, but I believe the Redhawks are that good.
In terms of our player of the game, Shawn, you give a team award. You look at some of the numbers here, though. I mean, Landry was almost unstoppable here today.
Yeah, I know, and only five carries. So five carries, 176 yards, three touchdowns, three touchdowns on five carries. But look at what Miles Freeman did, too. Again, he doesn't throw the ball very often, 2 of 2 passing.
I'd go along with Freeman, actually.
A couple of touchdowns. He threw the touchdown. He ran for 2 touchdowns on 3 carries, threw for just under 100 yards. That's going to be a tough call. Aaron Landry ended up with, Seth Worthley ended up with 7 carries for 43 yards. And Seth Gawanter, pretty much a day off for him. 4 carries, 22 yards, didn't need him much, didn't use him much. Bodes well for them again next week and the week after. Take a little workload off of him. Cole Price caught a couple touchdown passes as well. So,
throw his name in there, too. I would go either Landry or Freeman.
That's a tough one. You know what? I guess when you run for a pair of touchdowns and then throw a couple touchdowns, maybe Miles Freeman.
Miles Freeman.
Yeah.
You can't go wrong with a couple of these guys.
Aaron Landry. Yeah, it's a coin toss, really. Let's go Freeman, man. That kid's had a great season, and I'll tell you what, Landry's probably going to pick up another one of those shirts along the way. So let's go with quarterback Miles Freeman again. Senior, 6'1", 185. More efficient. You can't be more efficient than what he was today. 2 for 2 passing, 3 carries, 2 touchdowns on the ground, 3 for touchdowns. Again, just a complete dominant performance by the Redhawks all the way around.
And for the Greenfield Green Wave, there will come a time in future games and future seasons when R.J. Byrd will be talking on the postgame show about what a performance by Byrd today, because he has that kind of talent. Again, he went up against a very tough Red Hawk defense, but he showed what he can do with that long 65-yard touchdown run in the third quarter.
Absolutely, no doubt about it. And again, that was, you look back at the Greenfield Turners game last weekend, and had Byrd been in the backfield, you know, the chances of him being able to break one like that were pretty good, because we've seen him do it every time we've seen him play. He obviously was not there. They lose that game 8-0, and Byrd today, 20 carries, 120 yards. A touchdown. He did have a couple of fumbles, so you're going to want to clean that up too. But, oh, absolutely. Kid's just a sophomore. If not by the end of this season, next season, certainly by his senior year, that kid stays healthy, get him some blocking, and he's going to be exciting to watch.
40-12, Frontier over Greenfield is our final score here on Booster Day. Be with us again tomorrow morning for Patriots football, 10 o'clock pregame, 1 o'clock kickoff, the Patriots and Browns. Live from Cleveland, right here on Bear Country 95.3. Our next high school football broadcast is next Friday night. We'll be back at Turner's Falls High School. The Turner's Falls Indians taking on the Franklin Tech Eagles. 6:45 pregame, 7 o'clock kickoff right here on Bear Country. Final score for the final time here today. Frontier 40, Greenfield 12 on the CarQuest of Greenfield, South Deerfield, and Shelburne scoreboard. For my broadcast partner, Sean Hubert, studio producer Matt Gregory, I'm Jeff Tirrell. Thank you so much for joining us here today, and have a great rest of your weekend in Bear Country, everyone.